some of your heroes have been cowboys through the years. Today is your lucky day. Our next guest plays a city slicker turned ranch hand in Hallmark Channel's new original Summer Nights film, A Summer Romance. Please welcome back our good friend Ryan Paevey is here, everybody.
Hey,
oh, man. I'm telling you right now, he is a self-proclaimed mountain man.
Yep.
You must have been in your element in this film. Here's the deal. You play JR, a New York City real estate developer, but you go to Montana to try and convince Sam, played by the amazing Aaron Krakow, to try and convince her to sell you her ranch.
Right.
Right? You're out there in the country. But how does that go?
I mean, about as well as you would think going to someone and being like, hey, I'd like to buy your house and kick you out.
Not great.
Not so great. And then upon my arrival, I get stuck there because the airport's closed. And
right.
Why would the airport not be closed?
There you
go. And there's a summer festival, so there's no place to stay because it's a big popular thing there. And me, having been distracted real estate guy in New York, didn't think to make plans.
Right.
So okay. I got to stay on the ranch, and there's no dead weight on a farm. So being there on the ranch, so to speak, I get pulled into their day-to-day.
Right.
All of their little things like milking cows, I get to ride horses a lot,
right.
Stuff like
getting
that.
Your
all
feet
of the chores.
Wet.
Get my feet wet.
Right.
Literally getting my
you
feet
were
wet.
In your
reluctantly.
Elements.
Take a look.
The water is warm.
You sure about that?
Move it, cowboy.
All right. I guess I'm going in.
While we're young.
I'm working on it. Cut me some slack. Boots are new to me. Okay. Oh, yeah. I thought you said it was going to be warm.
It's just a figure of speech. When was the last time you walked through a stream?
The last time?
Mm-hmm.
I think your idea of warm and my idea of warm are very different things. See?
It's freezing!
I know.
Oh.
Fine.
That must have been so much fun!
It was super cold.
Beautiful.
But I was way into it, though. I love that stuff.
Yeah, you were so into that. I mean, you love the camping and all that stuff and the hiking. Your character, maybe not so much.
Maybe not so much.
But you also became very one with that cowboy hat that we saw you wearing. You said it changed your entire demeanor.
I did.
You put the hat on, I swear.
You'll have like a little twang in your voice a little bit, and you find when you walk, your heels kind of kick out a little bit.
Well, you can't help but not.
You can't help but not. And I actually would catch myself a couple of times. I'd just be like, what are you doing? But it's kind of fun, though.
And that was an original.
Oh, for sure. That
Stetson.
Was like a legit Stetson. That was, even the resident cowboys were like,
yeah.
The people who know that
fancy.
Know that.
I mean, you're one.
You
got a hat
myself.
Too. Yeah, of course.
And that belt buckle was
And the belt
was
buckle
pretty
was no joke
impressive.
Too. I mean, I was pretty decked out.
Well, it's not the only sort of fashion accessory, costume accessory that you love. That's for sure. People at home may be surprised to find out you also like to dress up like a pirate. You also go to Renaissance fairs.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, this is something that we don't. This is a little bit of a gift to everybody.
I like it, Ryan.
I've been going since I was a kid, man. I don't know. I mean, if you were an 8-year-old boy and your parents took you to the Ren Fair where there's like games and giant turkey legs and people walking around with swords and armor, it's like the awesomest thing ever for
absolutely.
An 8-year-old. It's the coolest thing ever. And then I just kept going, and now I'm not 8, but I still go. So
you love it.
It's
really super
fun.
I mean, it's just something that I've done since I was a child, so I don't know any other way.
I think it's cool. I'm giving you a hard time, but I think it's pretty fun.
And for somebody like you who loves to make jewelry out of leather and ropes, they do a lot of really cool crafts there.
There is a lot of, like, there's a commercial element to each one where a lot of artisans will get together, and it's all, like, handmade stuff.
It's They're so all, cool.
It's an interesting little, like, subculture there, people who still make stuff with their hands. I mean, are you going to get your next dish set there? Probably not. So the kinds of stuff that you get, I mean, you could, they sell cups. I have a couple. But it's just kind of cool to see a bunch of people who actually still work with their hands and make things, and it's all out there.
And you also still happen to hold the title as champ of what is it called?
Yeah, I don't know what it's called. You swing
the sledgehammer
and you hit the thing and you ring the bell. So I hold the record there.
Yeah.
They call me the Hammer.
That's impressive.
The Hammer.
They call Ryan the Hammer.
Jesus, JR, he's the Hammer, he's a mountain man.
My mom used to call me Flying Ryan, so we'll add that to the...
Why not? Put that in there as well. We've seen many sides of you today between the Ren Fair and the cowboy hat and Flying Ryan. There is one side of you, I know most of these sides, but this side that we're going to show people now, I was very surprised to see, and I have to say, my friend, as you age, you will be a very distinguished-looking older man. We have to show everyone these photos. Now, I thought that was some sort of, I thought they were prosthetics there. I really wasn't sure what I was looking at when they showed me this picture yesterday, but I'm going to tell you what, you're going to be very good-looking.
I appreciate it.
As you age.
That's great. I can't wait to
see
that.
What is this about?
So all of my friends and my managers and everybody was doing this thing, this face app thing, right? And I didn't even know what it was. And I was on this camping trip with my dad, and I had gotten a text message from my manager, and I was just like, all right, I'll plug a picture into this thing. And I, given what I do for a living, it's kind of comedic how I avoid the camera. So all of the pictures that I have of my face, because everybody's like, you used a headshot. I'm like, what? It's the only pictures of my face I have, man. Yeah. I'm not like, I don't take selfies. It's not a thing. So that was just one of the ones that I had, and I was just like, all right, I'll put it in here, and that's what popped up. And I sent it to my guys, and they're like, I hate you.
And look at that.
Oh, that's from the movie.
Another one. There you go. There you go.
I think you're the only one who's used this app and looked better.
He has. I mean,
it's shocking.
It's incredible. And as much as the fans out there love seeing you, obviously, as a cowboy, as a silver fox, I think they like you most holding some puppies, which we saw you recently. This was the Summer Nights preview special. You were part of it, and they loved it. And I had a quote here somewhere. Let me see if I can find it. Somebody even said, a sexy man with a puppy. Yep, my day is complete. There it is right there. You got it. They love it, man. How was that?
I miss them already. I miss them. I had two. There was two. There was Sadie was the paler of the two who really liked the bottom of my nose a lot. And then there was a darker one that, like, the moment they brought the puppies on set, ran up to me. It was like attached to my chest the whole time. So I basically had the two of them the whole time. And then we had to move on from the segment, and you could see the person coming to you, and they're going to take the dogs. And I don't want there.
But you want to have. So are you going to get one?
You can adopt one.
So I made a deal with myself that if I didn't just, you know, break and adopt, that I would wait until I had like a home. And I'm working on that.
Okay.
So when I have a home and I have a yard for them to go crazy in,
there you go.
Then they can go crazy, and then it'll be great. No hate for apartment living with your pup. Don't get me wrong.
Right.
I just always kind of made the deal with myself that if I had it to choose, that's how I would do it.
To have land for them to run
and
feed dogs. You're exactly right. I agree with that. Well, I would also love for you to do something for us, because we love you with puppies, but we also love you as that cowboy. Will you do me a favor? Will you look down the lens, and will you take us out the cowboy way?
Yeah, we can do that. You guys make sure to catch my next Hallmark movie airing Saturday, August 17th, 9/8 Central, right here on Hallmark Channel. Y'all come back now, you hear.
Oh, there it is right there.
And
that's
I like
right.
how you didn't overdo it.
He didn't overdo it.
What?
It was just, that was good.
Perfect.
That was just enough cowboy.